TV is no longer just for TV. More and more viewers are tuning into the web to catch shows specifically made for online. Now, CBC is getting into the game. As Deanna Sumanak-Johnson shows us, it comes as the second annual TO Webfest gets set to kick off this weekend.
Give us a clap. Go, Kate.
Out With Dad, a Canadian show focusing on a gay teenager coming out to her father, has been viewed more than 25 million times on the internet.
Again, I just want it to be a little...
That makes its writer-director Jason Lever a poster boy for web series creators everywhere.
How long have you been a lesbian?
Mom!
He put the first episode online 5 years ago.
I didn't know anyone in the TV world, so I'm like, well, you know, maybe I just do it myself. And the web was still kind of a new-ish option at the time.
But since then, web series have blossomed in quantity and quality. More sophisticated than your average YouTube video, but far more rough-looking than an expensively produced Netflix show like House of Cards. Web series are also short, from 3 to 10 minutes per episode, so they can be viewed on mobile devices.
60% of our audience, they're watching it on their device, so they could be in their room enjoying this very intimate personal story in a very intimate and personal way.
And that connection with the viewer, coupled with low production costs, is why big broadcasters are now getting in on the game.
Let's make a show.
Starting in June, CBC will stream episodes of the web series Body Buds on its comedy website Punchline. The show's creators say they welcome the cachet of making a web series with a major broadcaster.
It's a bit more produced, there's a bit more of a team behind it, and the production value is higher.
And it could become even higher. This CBC exec says that if a web series like Body Buds is a hit online...
It is also a process by which we can develop and find the kernel that would work on television.
A win-win situation for creators and broadcasters in the world where series come in all shapes and sizes, and content, not the medium, is the most important thing. Deanna Sumanak-Johnson, CBC News, Toronto.